You look at my screen right here, and what do you see? I Googled the term SEO. It's a popular term. Gets over 110,000 searches in the United States per month, and it even has a $9.49 cost per click. And you see Google ranking at the top, and Moz, and Search Engine Land, and Wikipedia, of course. And wait, what do you see here? Neil Patel. That's my own website. But you know what? Popular keywords aren't the best keywords. This keyword is almost useless for me. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down why popular keywords aren't the best keywords. Now before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. So you're probably wondering, hey Neil, what do you mean by popular keywords aren't the best keywords? SEO, great keyword, you get a lot of traffic for it, right? And I do. But this article is on what is SEO. If you can also see here, if I go to, you know, the top of the article, it's all on beginner stuff. Beginner's Guide to SEO, SEO 101, you know, what is SEO? Literally, it's a lot of beginner stuff. And I myself make money by selling SEO services and marketing services in general for my ad agency, NP Digital. But as you can see here, none of the people who are ranking really cover service-related stuff. More so, they're just here to tell you what SEO is or the definition. On the flip side, you know, I rank for a term that gets a lot less traffic, SEO company. And when I look at SEO company, you're seeing other people rank there, and I'm not as high. Just started this page a while ago. And this one's still on page one. This page right here generates me roughly one new customer every other month. So that's roughly six customers a year. This page, roughly one customer a year. So the one that doesn't rank as high is generating me roughly one customer every other month, so six a year, versus the one that gets more traffic is only getting me one a year. But when you look at the volume for this, it doesn't get 110,000 searches a month, only gets 18,000. The point I'm trying to make is the most popular keywords typically aren't the best keywords. So how do you find the right keywords? Well, first off, they're not typically head terms like one word like insurance or SEO. You know, there's a lot of different types of insurance. If I was a car company or a car insurance company, I wouldn't want to rank for insurance. I would want to rank for auto insurance or even better, auto insurance quotes. Right? It's very specific where someone looking it up wants quotes and they're interested in the service. So I want you to go to ubersuggest, neilpatel.com/ubersuggest, or just go to ubersuggest.com and type in keywords related to your space. So I'll type in SEO here, and what you'll want to do is scroll down and you can see a lot of different ideas. You can click view all, you can see suggestions. I like going into the related keywords, and the related keywords show you, all right, what are all the keywords that are very similar? Here's SEO company, that's an example of one. If I go into suggestions, you know, you can see quite a few as well. SEO marketing, SEO with Google, SEO definition. It just shows you longer tail variations. So just a general rule of thumb when you're going through all of this. Number one, you want to look for ideally three word phrases. The longer the phrase, probably the better. Number two, you want to look for keywords with high CPC. High CPC, like this one, SEO website, someone who's Googling it typically is looking to do SEO for a website or need helps with it. Higher CPC means higher conversion. SEO expert, as you can see here, that's someone like, hey, I'm looking for an SEO expert, $31 cost per click. And you can do this for a lot of terms, like I'll Google the term digital marketing. Or more so search on Ubersuggest. And I can see a lot of suggestions here. Digital marketing agency. It's not as difficult to rank for compared to digital marketing, but yet the cost per click is higher. What does that mean? It's gonna drive you more revenue in most cases. So look for the longer tail terms that have a high CPC, you know, compared to the head terms, and have an SEO difficulty score ideally of 50 or lower. That means it's easier to rank for. And as you scroll down, you'll find them. You know, like digital marketing consultant, good CPC, the search volume's not bad, but the SEO difficulty is high. And I can keep scrolling, and eventually, as I scroll more and more, I'll find these keywords. So let's say I go to the next page. You know, I actually can click on related. That'll even give me more suggestions. Manager digital marketing. So someone's looking for a digital marketing manager to hire. You can have a page that talks about how to hire one. And if they want, they can just outsource it to your company and save the hassle. Has a decent cost per click, has a good volume, and it's a 12 on a scale from how hard is it to rank for. Lower the number, the better. That's green. That's easy. So, and I can keep scrolling and I can find more terms like digital marketing agencies near me. Good CPC. That means someone's looking for an agency, and you can have a page on, you know, what agency based on cities like Los Angeles, New York, London, etc. And that gets good amount of searches, good CPC, easy difficulty when it comes to ranking for. Those are the type of terms that you want to rank for, and you want to create content around that. That's how you do well. That's how you don't just get SEO traffic, but you get SEO traffic that generates revenue. It doesn't matter if you get 10 million visitors or 1 million visitors a month or even 1,000 visitors a month. The question is how much money you're making for those visitors. And the real way to make the most is don't go after popular terms like the term SEO. Go after terms that are more specific. Like I bet you the term digital marketing agencies near me would drive me way more money in the long run than just ranking on Google for the term SEO, because everyone who searches for SEO is more so looking around the basics and the definition versus this term, digital marketing agencies near me, someone's looking to hire an agency. That's more likely to generate you more income. And there's just so many of these terms out there. You just got to keep looking for them. And I can keep going here, you know, digital marketing agencies in Los Angeles. So I used to be based in Southern California, not anymore. I used to live in Los Angeles, but we have staff in Los Angeles. So that could be a very relevant term for us. Good difficulty, 49 under 50, as I mentioned. Decent CPC, which means it converts, and decent enough volume. So if you go with this strategy, you can do well in the long run. If you have any questions, leave them comment below. I'm here to help you out. If you just want my team to do all of this for you, check out my ad agency, NP Digital. And if you like this video, share it, like it, tell the people about it. Thank you for watching.